What does it mean when we pray in the name of Jesus? I know a lot of people do pray in the name of Jesus. Either they pray by using it to start a prayer, in Jesus' name we pray, then they start praying, or they end a prayer with it. After praying, they said, in Jesus' name we pray, amen. But then I'm not here to argue about which one is right, starting a prayer with in the name of Jesus or ending a prayer with the name of Jesus. I'm actually here to talk about the in-depth understanding of that. Do you even understand why we pray like that and say in the name of Jesus? Do you have an understanding of it? Do you have a knowledge of it? What does it mean to even say, I am praying in the name of Jesus? John chapter 14 verse 13 to 14 says, you can ask for anything in my name. This was Jesus speaking. And I will do it so that the Son can bring glory to the Father. Speaking about himself, bringing glory to God. Verse 14 says, yes, ask me for anything in my name and I will do it. Again, Mark chapter 16 verse 17, talking about his name, it says, these miraculous signs will accompany those who believe. They will cast out demons in my name, and they will speak in new languages, that is speaking in tongues. When he says praying in my name or asking for things in my name or casting demons in my name, it means there's something special about his name. There's something about his name that we need to understand so that when we pray, we do not just see in the name of Jesus as maybe let me stamp my prayer with the name of Jesus without an in-depth understanding of using his name or praying with his name. Because I feel like this is the reason a lot of people get to pray and use their pastor's name or whatsoever person's name. Jesus' name is the greatest name to be used. But now, before we even get to that, let's get to this aspect of what does name represent. The Greek word, when I studied, for name means onoma, O-N-O-M-A. Onoma. I don't know. I'm not a Greek person, so I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right. But then it actually means character, authority, interest, pleasure, command, excellencies, deed. It means these are what name represents. The name of a person represents the person's character. It represents the person's authority, which is why people don't want their name to be soiled, because they're like, don't go and soil my name and defame my character. Because if their name is soiled or someone uses their name to lie, they have soiled their name. That represents their character, their integrity, who they are. So when we talk about Jesus, or talk about the name of Jesus, we are talking about Jesus' character. We are talking about Jesus' integrity. We are talking about Jesus' pleasure. What makes him happy? What is his pleasure? What does he love to do? Of course, one of the things I know that he loves to do is that he loves to heal. He loves to bless. He loves to lift broken people. He loves to make people that were in down places to be raised up. So this is one of his pleasure. It means I can use his name. And what other thing is commands? His presence, his name represents that, his commands. His name represents his excellencies. His name represents his deeds, which means when I get to study the scripture, I get to see the deeds of Jesus. I can now use his name because I've seen his name represents the things he has done. When we talk about praying in the name of Jesus, coming to a deeper understanding of this, you have to know that scripture talks about sometimes we pray and we do not receive because we pray amiss. How do we pray amiss? It means our prayer do not get to agree with Jesus' character. Maybe you do not get to agree with Jesus' pleasure. Maybe it's just your ambition and not the purpose of God for you. And Jesus is like, if I give you this, you're going to destroy your life, and I love you. So it's not my pleasure to see you destroy your life with your own hands, so I'm going to say no to this. And sometimes when he says no, we are like, God did not answer my prayer. This is not like funny, but then it's just the impression that makes it look funny, because it's a real thing that people really desire a lot of things and they don't get to receive it and they feel bad about it. But then you have to trust Jesus. You have to trust that if you're praying in his name and if it's in line with his will, he's going to do it for you. And if he does not do it for you, it means you need to check your prayer again and check what you are looking for again and ask him to direct you to the right path. Name is really powerful because it conveys everything that the name covers. So when we talk about the name of Jesus, the scripture clearly states that no other name is given among men that men would be saved. And in Philippians chapter 2 verse 9 to 11, it says about the name of Jesus, therefore God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name. This is the greatest name. That at the name of Jesus, that is why we pray in the name of Jesus. That at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow of those in heaven and of those on earth and of those under the earth. Covers everything about the universe. In heaven, on earth, under the earth, the whole universe submits to the name of Jesus. So there's no power, there's no demon, there's no principality, there's nothing that can stand the name of Jesus. We as his children just need to stand in agreement with his name, in agreement with his character, in agreement with his command, in agreement with his pleasure, in agreement with his authority. I feel like this is why Jesus could tell the disciples, I give unto you authority to trample on serpents and scorpion and upon all the powers of the enemy, and nothing by any means shall hurt you. Why? Because you are standing on the greatest name that is given amongst men, under the earth, above in the heavens, that this is the greatest name. And the next verse says, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, which means this conveys the idea of him, Jesus, being Lord of all, Lord of everything. This is why you can have the authority to use his name. And when you use his name to pray in the name of Jesus, you understand deeply that you're standing not in your own authority. That you're standing not in the authority of your righteous works, of your self-righteousness. That you're standing not on the authority of the fact that God have been singing for you, so do this for me. He says, no, use my name, not your acts. So that you will not come and say, God, I've blessed people, so come and visit me. He says, don't use that. Don't use your works. Don't use your self-righteousness, because they are not worthy. Use my name. My name is worthy for you to use to receive the things you need and the blessings I want to give you. I will ask this question. Does Jesus want you healed? Scripture says he went from place to place, healing all that were sick and oppressed. All, not few, not some, not those that call for him, but all that were sick and oppressed. He lifted the oppressed. Again, it says by stripes you are healed. So now the answer is yes. Jesus wants you healed. The evidence is in his word. It agrees with his character. It agrees with his command. It agrees with what makes him happy. Going from place to place, seeing sick people call to him, and he will heal them. I heard something beautiful just some days back, that Jesus healed people and would not ask them to believe in him, which means he did not put a price tag on his healing. He did not put a price tag on his blessings. He did not put a price tag on whatever thing he did for people. It was just being benevolent to them. We humans, we put price tags on things. Like, I healed you, come on, follow me. Don't even, like, don't be playing. After healing you, were walking away, follow me. But then he didn't ask anyone to follow him. Some people that he healed and they wanted to follow him, he would even tell them, no, go to meet your people. You need them more than following me. He didn't put a price tag, which means we don't receive the blessings and the favors of God and the healing of God based on the things we are able to do to be worthy of it. So now I can tell you that you can ask for your healing right now, even now, in the name of Jesus. That the healing, the headache that is disturbing you right now ceases, because by stripes you are healed. That whatever thing you're feeling in your bones, whatever heat you're feeling in your heart, on your body, any part of your body, that you are healed right now. Whatever thing is happening in your body that is not in line with the character of Christ, in the name of Jesus, be healed. Amen. I'll ask this question. Does Jesus want you to be prosperous? A lot of Christians do not believe that Jesus wants them to be prosperous. They think that the riches that Jesus talks about when he talks about riches is the riches of the kingdom. No, Jesus talks about money. Because he knows on earth here you need money. He knows on earth here you need to survive. He knows on earth here you need to be a blessing. And the scripture says in Acts of the Apostle that it is blessed to give than to receive. Talking about us horizontally as humans. It is blessed to give than to receive. It is blessed for you to be a giver than to be a tax collector. Like you're walking around begging people, asking from people. You should aim to come to a place of becoming wealthy to be a blessing, be a giver. I'm not trying to say this to mock anybody that does not have and wants to ask for help. But then there are people who are professional tax collectors in this our day who just wants to go about asking people for money, entering people's DM, going on comments on social media posts and expressing how they are suffering, how they have three kids. I don't know what spirit just came over me, but let me leave that alone. So anyways, it is about you knowing Jesus wants you prosperous. It is written all over the pages of scripture that I wish that you may prosper and be in health, even as your soul prospers. And it said again that he became poor, Jesus himself. He that was rich became poor, so that out of his poverty you'll be rich. Let me read that scripture in 2 Corinthians chapter 8, verse 9. You know the generous grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Though he was rich, yet for your sakes he became poor, so that by his poverty he could make you rich. Make who rich? You and me. He became poor not because he didn't want to be rich. Jesus came to earth as God. He would have entered into any rich family. He would have been born in the palace. Of course, the king expected that this prophecy would be fulfilled in the palace, because we are talking about the king of the Jews. So he should have come from the palace. That was why they were all about trying to kill him. He didn't come from the palace. He came from the lowliest place. He became poor. He was not made poor. He chose poverty. Why did he choose poverty? So that today you and I should not and would not choose poverty. Don't choose poverty, my friend. Choose to be blessed. Choose to be wealthy. And I know there are a lot of people who are poor because they choose it. They feel like being poor is the will of God for their life. Well, if that's what you believe, good for you. I don't believe same. That's why I believe God for riches, for wealth, for God to bless me. Scripture says in Deuteronomy that God is the one that gives us the power to get wealth. Just read the Bible. I feel like when you get to study your Bible, you get to know what aligns with the character of Christ. You get to know what aligns with the authority of Christ, so that when you pray in the name of Jesus, it will be like this faith that is almost like it's a pulse. It's a pulse of faith on your heart. Like, I believe what I'm saying. I'm not just praying to get to convince God. I'm not trying to convince God. I already believe. I have a conviction in him that he will do what he said, that he said this, he promised this, he's going to do it. So I hope this blesses you to know that praying in the name of Jesus is more than just in the name of Jesus. And you start your prayer, oh, Father in heaven, I thank you, Lord Jesus, and all of that. And it's in the name of Jesus, amen. It's beyond that. It should come from a place of deep understanding and faith, praying in that name. I am Uwem. Thank you for watching today's video. And it will be a pleasure of mine to have you watch more of my videos. If you want to see more of such videos like this, do not forget to subscribe and to hit the like button and to drop a comment of how this is impacting you. It will be my pleasure to chat with you. Thank you and God bless you. Bye-bye.